Hey, my name is Robin Relio, and today I'm going to share to you one of my favorite breakfast recipes, Tapsilog. Cooking has always been a passion of mine, since I really like that you're able to experiment with different ingredients, with different recipes, to be able to create something new. I think cooking is one thing everyone should learn how to. It's not really that hard if you exert the effort into it. You don't really need to be someone special in order to learn how to cook. You only need to exert your time and your effort into learning how to. So considering that this quarantine, we really have a lot of time to burn, I'm going to try this YouTube thing and upload some of my experiment cooking videos in YouTube. So to start it off, I'm going to share to you an easy and quick basic recipe about Tapsilog. Here's a little background. Tapsilog is an acronym for tapa, garlic rice, and egg, which is sometimes paired with some sides such as tomato slices to help balance the saltiness of the tapa in some recipes. It's popularly served as a breakfast staple in different eateries around the Philippines. It also has roots as far as the pre-Hispanic era in where Filipinos would preserve meat under the sun. Tapsilog is known to be very easy and satisfying to make. It started to become popular in Manila in the late 1980s around Carinderias and Tapsihans because it was very inexpensive. The main component of Tapsilog is its meat. Tapa, which is basically dried, sometimes soft meat marinated in soy sauce, garlic, sugar, calamansi, and sometimes vinegar. I think all of us would agree that we all have our own versions of Tapsilog in our households.
As the late great Doreen Fernandez mentions in her book, The Kim, we Filipinos have took a lot of recipes from our foreign neighbors and have made meals according to our own tastes and the ingredients available to us.
So for different households, some would like their tapa mild, balanced, or even spicy, and some would use beef sirloin, venison, boar, or even horse meat. And that's what I think is special about Filipino cuisine, since we all have our own different versions of it.
For my version, I wanted to mimic the delicious tapa inspired by Doreen Fernandez's description in her book, En Tapsi ni Vivian, a famous eatery here in the Philippines. You start with marinating your tapa with soy sauce, sugar, calamansi, vinegar, and pepper, and leave it in the fridge for a day or two. It's better to leave it longer to marinate so you get softer and more flavorful tapa. After that, the rest is basically just searing your tapa until golden brown. Prepare your sunny side golden egg and garlic rice.
And that is it. Please comment, like, and subscribe. And tell me what you think of this first video. I really want to learn your thoughts on how I did for this first month. Bye!